Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about the top 5 technical skills that a Salesforce admin can have. So now there are a lot of different technical skills that a Salesforce admin can have and can learn. Personally, I think that you should always be learning different skills, whether it's soft skills or technical skills, to one, do better in your current job as well as learn more so then you can do more in your next job and kind of move up within the ecosystem. I always think that you should be looking for and learning more to do. So that's my little spiel. Let's go ahead and jump into these 5 skills. The first one is going to be SQL. This is the Salesforce Object Query Language. I find this to be really important, especially if you're working in a large system with a lot of automations, maybe a lot of code, to understand this. The Salesforce Object Query Language helps us to pull different data sets and different records based upon the different criteria that you might set. This is very similar to running a report, but personally I like to use the Workbench tool to query the different records within Salesforce, maybe if I'm moving data around or I'm trying to figure out what's going wrong with the data or test an automation. The SQL queries are also used in the data loader, and so it is a really simple tool to use once you understand how to query within SQL and within Salesforce. SQL is a very similar version of a query language to SQL, which is just a system query language. So if you understand SQL, then you will understand SQL. A lot of it is just I want to grab this type of record from this data set and only the records that start with the letter J. That is a lot of how SQL works. Specifically, if you wanted to get only opportunities related to a specific account, then you'd be able to do that using a SQL query. Again, it's very similar to creating a report with the different filters that you have just in a single line of code or maybe a few lines of code. One course that I did take was the SQL Bootcamp, and that helped me a lot to understand SQL. So once I got started on the Salesforce platform, I was already familiar with the query language. All right, number 2 is going to be flows. Flows are the biggest automation tool that we have within Salesforce, and Salesforce is really pushing us to use flows now. You can do so many different things with flows. You can create, you can edit, you can delete, you can update different things. You can call API, you can call triggers, all these different things. And it is a really useful thing to know because this is the future of our automations. They're going to be getting rid of workflow roles and process builders. And so understanding how to do the different types of flows and create these automations that you would have previously done using a workflow role and a process builder will just make your life a lot easier. As far as a course or a tool to understand flows better, I'm currently taking the Salesforce Lightning Flows course on Udemy. I found it really, really helpful to get a better understanding of flows and how to use them and when you'd want to use them. Also, the instructor is really awesome and he updates the course very frequently. So I'll link that down below if you want to check it out. All right, the next one is going to be formulas. Formulas are different sets of logic that you can use to automate, to query, to calculate different things. It's used a lot in different one-off automation tools, such as case automation tools or lead automation tools. And based upon a certain set of criteria, then it routes the different records different ways. I know that was a really complicated explanation, but when you are trying to route a lead a certain way, you can create a formula to take any web-based leads that came in before noon. You can put them with one user who's going to work on them, and any phone-based leads that came in afternoon, you can send them to another user. I found that formulas are a really useful tool to use, and they can either be really simple or really complicated, especially when you're using validation rules. This might be one of the more important things that you want to learn and understand how to do within Salesforce. It are these different formulas. So be sure to practice these and understand the objective before jumping into a formula. That's my number one tip for formulas. Number four is going to be troubleshooting skills, especially not getting super heated when you are coming to troubleshooting different things. This could be the formulas, this could be a SQL query, this could be a flow, this could be the different errors that your users are coming up with. Being able to figure out why something is happening and trying to come up with a solution and testing it is a really important skill to have. Now, some people might qualify this as a soft skill, but I really think it is more of a technical skill to be able to take an error or an issue that you're having and figure out the solution within a quick manner on the different technical aspects of Salesforce. All right, and number five is going to be the ability to work with large data sets within Salesforce. I don't think I've ever come up with a job, or I've never had a job where I haven't had to use a large data set and taken it out of Salesforce and then put it back into Salesforce. This could be either uploading their previous clients, this could be doing some type of data analysis that I can't do within the usual reporting tools or dashboarding tools within Salesforce, or fixing certain things within a large data set. So using Excel and understanding how to use Excel is really, really helpful and useful as an admin who will be working with a large data set especially. So that is the final technical skill that I have for you. I hope that you found this helpful. And I hope that you are able to learn more on the platform and to gain more technical skills so then you can move up in the Salesforce world, as well as be able to create better solutions and do things with better ease within the Salesforce platform. If you like this video, be sure to give it a like, subscribe, check out the courses down below that I have on Salesforce, on Udemy. If you'd like to join the family, you can do so at salesforceemily.com and join the email list there. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.